Why is dry cleaning one of America's most promising industries? This is your answer, a tremendous market. Everyone, everywhere is your prospect. How many of the thousands who pass your door, who are in your neighborhood, are your customers? Have you sold yourself and your service to the limit? There are three simple steps you can take that will bring in more clothes from which you get your pay dirt. Just three things to do, and here they are. Modernize your business methods. Make salesmen out of rootmen and counter clerks. Use a definite advertising campaign.
Modernize your business methods.
Let's look at them one at a time and see how any dry cleaner can take these three steps to greater profits. Here's an example of a storefront that's all too common in the industry. No matter how good a job of cleaning this house does, very few people would realize it from the outside appearance. Nor does the inside offer any more attraction. Yet this is a cleaning establishment, and customers expect it to be as clean as a bakery or any other store into which they go to spend money. And rightfully so.
Swell day, Joe. Gives you that old peppy feeling. How's business?
Lousy. What can you expect? A guy just can't make any dough.
Oh, I don't know, Joe. Things look pretty good to me.
For you, yeah. But who gets clothes cleaned these days? I'm lucky to keep open at all the way business is around here.
It isn't enough for Joe that his shop looks down at the mouth. He has to be that way, too. He sells the world short, and he's also selling himself short. The next time that customer has a garment to be cleaned, he'll remember Joe's sour face and go somewhere else. This is where he'll go, a store with a great big welcome written all over it. And it's no larger than Joe's. Just a little paint and a pail of water makes a lot of difference. The smart appearance of modern dry cleaning plants invites customers in. Size is not the important thing here. The smallest shop may have the most attractive appearance, as many dry cleaners today are proving. What this man has done is apply common sense to his entire operation. First, in the appearance of his shop and the mental attitude he adopts.
Will you give this a cleaning, please?
Yes, sir.
Great day, isn't it?
Fine day. I'll have this for you tomorrow afternoon. May I have the name, please?
J.D. Bevins. B-E-V-I-N-S. 314 Brown Street. How's business?
Fine. Improving every day.
Swell. I'll be seeing you.
Good day, sir.
The customer will remember this cleaner's pleasant smile and optimistic attitude. He'll enjoy coming back. Meanwhile, the garment goes through the plant in a cycle that is thoughtfully planned for efficiency and space requirements. Then a record of this transaction is important. A simple yet effective record-keeping system is your best bet toward future business. Be sure you have the name and address of every customer. A card in this file shows the time and type of work done. And letters or phone calls will keep customers aware of this company's service. Customers, people for whom you've done work in the past, are your best prospects. They are the easiest to get more volume from and the cheapest to get back if they have stopped coming in. So keep a record and keep in touch.
Good morning, Mrs. Smith. This is the Ideal Cleaners. We'd like to remind you of the coming holidays. You'll probably want some of your dresses and your husband's suits cleaned and ready ahead of time. Shall we have the driver stop by this afternoon? Thank you, Mrs. Smith.
Next in importance in your modern plant setup is a complete service. For the cleaner such as this one, without space to install complete equipment, arrangements can be made at a nearby storage house for this service, from which you get cleaning business and a commission on stored garments. Similar arrangements can be made so that your service, regardless of the size of your plant, includes furniture and rug cleaning. A complete service is a convenience to your customers, and each new service is a profit item to you. Now you're ready to step out and sell. To begin with, you must have a planned program of sales operation over which you are a constant general. Your territory should be studied and mapped out intelligently. If you have more than one route man, this territory should be divided fairly. Then quotas can be set for each man based on your established business, plus an estimated amount of new business. The route man who fills his quota deserves a bonus, and he'll work harder if he gets one. But give a man a break. If you want more business, see that he has time to solicit. If each route man makes a stipulated number of new calls each day, you'll soon have enough new prospects to warrant putting on another truck. It's your job to show your route man where to find these new prospects. And one of the first places to look is the old reliable city directory, providing a ready-made mailing and calling list. Your own customers, of course, can supply a prospect list from among their friends. And you go on these new calls with a real recommendation. A stranger in your community is naturally a prospect for dry cleaning. The new family will often be listed in the local paper, or a moving company can provide the tip. Apartment house and building superintendents can lead you to plenty of business, and it often happens that a milkman or some other non-competitive routeman will have a profitable tip. Keep that customer file in mind at this point. A timely phone call will probably mean a pickup. Then keep it your men to use their own eyes while they're on the route. This stop is a natural if you handle both dry cleaning and laundry. A laundryman who takes on dry cleaning or a dry cleaner who expands to include laundry is doubling the profit from each call. The same truck and the same routeman can sell both these services. So here is your routeman, representing a completely modern establishment with a list of new prospects on which to call. What happens next? Is this man capable of telling an intelligent sales story? You must make him capable.
Make salesmen out of routemen and counter clerks.
This means that unless you have a very large plant, you will have to become a sales manager, and you'll have to hold sales meetings. These meetings should be called profit meetings, and in them you should show your people how to sell, then make them want to sell. It will not be enough to tell them. You'll have to lead them, sell them on selling. The meetings must be well planned. They must be short and to the point, and they must send your people out full of ideas and pep. The best way to lead people is to give them simple catchphrases they can remember, such as know yourself, know your customer, know your service, know your sales talk. This is an early morning meeting. Suppose we see how our friend the proprietor gets the first point across.
We've decided that know yourself includes appearance, the way you sell yourself to customers, and the confidence you have in yourselves and this company. John, you seem to be having difficulty in bringing in new customers. You think this point explains your trouble?
Well, I don't know. I guess I'm as neat as the next fellow. I always smile at the dame.
Well, that's a good beginning if the smile is sincere. But it isn't getting results. Who was the last prospect you called on?
Well, I tried Mrs. Gordon over on 12th Street last Friday, but nothing done.
But suppose you come up here and pretend I'm Mrs. Gordon. Just what did you say to her last Friday?
Well, when she come to the door, I says, good afternoon, Mrs. Gordon. I'm John Peters with the Ideal Cleaners. And she, I says, I'd like to pick up some of your clothes to be cleaned the next time you have some. And she wouldn't even take this leaflet.
I don't blame her, John. We're in the cleaning business, and everything about us should look clean, clothes, truck, and the literature we hand our customers. That's a lesson we're learning because we're still young. The first truck salesman I had was a honey. Almost the first call he made was at the home of a man who had dropped by on his way to work and told us to pick up a suit. That salesman didn't bother to have his truck cleaned up. Nor did he worry much about keeping himself looking neat in those days. So he neither felt nor looked particularly good when the lady opened the door.
Yes?
The Ideal Cleaners.
Well?
Ain't you got any cleaning? Your husband told me to stop.
No, I'm sorry. I haven't any cleaning.
Okay, lady, but this is the address they gave me.
That man didn't get the order, of course. Nor did he ever get one from that home. He made a bad first impression with his appearance and a bad last impression with his attitude.
Yeah, I bet you got rid of that guy in a hurry.
No, I just talked it over with him and he knows better now. He's one of our best salesmen. Isn't that right, Frank?
Well, I don't know about that best salesman stuff, but I pulled plenty of boners when I was learning the business, and I've got plenty to learn yet. I have learned that both first and last impressions are about the most important things in selling, and I try to make them good.
Let's help the others to get past some of those mistakes, Frank. Just how do you treat a customer now?
I keep that first and last impression idea in mind from the very beginning of a call. And the truck is always clean, inside and out. And I try to look brisk and businesslike as I'm going up to the door. If I had that call the boss was talking about to do over again, I'll bet it would be different.
Well?
Good morning, Mrs. Miller. I'm from Ideal Cleaners. Mr. Miller stopped by the store this morning and asked us to pick up one of his suits. Do you have it ready?
Well, I don't know. Oh, yes. That must be why he left this one here. When will you have it back?
Well, will Friday be all right?
Yes, that's fine.
I'd like you to keep this, Mrs. Miller, and look through it when you have a chance. You'll notice that we're completely equipped and prepared to do the finest work on many things besides your clothes. Here's where we clean and revitalize hats. These are drapes and slip covers. We do a beautiful job on blankets and most anything else you can think of.
Thank you very much.
Most women will page through a leaflet if you put it into their hands. That'll give them some idea of the other things that they can give me when I come back.
That's a healthy contrast to your earlier calls, Frank. I wish you'd come up here again, John, and try out that same approach before we leave with Doris as a customer.
Get them on their feet. Lead your salesman through a planned program of sales fundamentals. Then have them practice in front of an audience. Let them act out their parts in front of you so that you can help them and so they become confident. Keep at them as often as you have time and can plan interesting, profitable meetings. Maybe the next meeting is one in which your employees get things off their chests.
I lost a good customer this week because we couldn't get the stain off the collar of her dress, even on the second try. Now, what can a guy do in a case like that?
That's a good question to put under Know Your Service. And the only answer is to be honest. Cleaning naturally has its limitations, and when the time comes, you should explain that to your customer. I heard Doris do it very nicely last week. You remember the lady I mean, Doris?
Why, yes. She came in with a hopelessly soiled dress and wanted it back the same day. So I told her, "Oh, I'm sorry, I can't promise this dress for today, Mrs. Harris. Our spotter may have to take some extra time on these stains. In fact, he may not be able to remove all of them entirely."
I don't see why I should leave a dress here if you can't get the spots out.
We'll do the best job it's possible to do, Mrs. Harris. Certain stains just can't be removed, particularly if they're set. If the spots don't come out entirely, we'll be able to fix them so they're not noticeable, and the dress will be thoroughly cleaned and satisfactory to wear.
The point is, don't try to kid the public. You know the kind of equipment we have and the kind of work we do. Tell your customers an honest story about the kind of service we offer, and they'll like you better for it.
You mean we should know as much as possible about what can and can't be done in the plant?
Exactly. I can promise you that the man who's on his toes about the kind of service we offer will get more business.
We sure get more since we tried rounding out our service. Now, I fell into a swell spot the other day. I just called at this house because I hadn't had a call from her for some time, and the lady was right in the midst of window washing. So, of course, I told her how we're prepared to get her drapes out of the way and bring them back bright and clean when she's ready. Then I gave her a selling on our method of handling slip covers. I got the drapes, the slip covers, and two hats she didn't know we could clean. All told, I think that was a pretty fat order.
That's fine, Frank. The more complete we can make our service to each customer, the more profit there'll be for us.
I'm afraid I don't get much chance to sell a complete service at the county.
You can always sell more service if you'll always keep in mind what we're capable of handling. I notice we get fewer press-only jobs since you've been suggesting to customers that our scientific cleaning adds life to garments and that we're equipped to have them ready the same day.
Yes, they're usually surprised that we can do a cleaning job so quickly.
You can suggest that customers bring something back with them when they come to pick up the garment, too. And keep the seasons in mind and remind them of top coats, summer suits, sportswear, and other things they might not have thought of.
That's the best way to train your employees, to make salespeople out of them. Find out what their problems are, then show them what to do, how to control every situation. Tell them exactly what to say. Put selling words into their mouths. That's the fourth fundamental this dry cleaner has set up. Know your sales talk. Show them how to ask for garments to take back. Show them the right and the wrong way to approach prospects under different conditions. Show them how to handle complaints and to answer questions. Then have them practice on each other. The difference between a rootman and a salesman is knowing what to say and how to say it. Not just any words, but selling words that bring in more pay dirt.
Know your customer. The second on the list of selling fundamentals is often the most important.
If your salesmen know their customers, they can make friends with them. They have the opportunity to be helpful and courteous, doing little things every day on their routes that make more friends and more sales. It will pay you to coach the men who drive your trucks and wear your emblems to acquire the habit of a friendly, helpful exterior, to take a few extra seconds to hang up heavy garments, to do many other things that leave pleasant impressions with everyone on the route. Little courtesies, especially while driving the truck, make lasting impressions that pay dividends. And the businessman or salesman who knows his customers also knows that they demand prompt, courteous attention.
Can you clean this dress today, please?
Okay, lady, okay. Just a minute.
Can you clean this dress today, please?
Shirley?
What is the name, please?
Mrs. Corbett. 410 Elizabeth Street.
Our finishers are expert at handling this type of dress, Mrs. Corbett, and I'm sure you'll be pleased with our method of individualized cleaning.
Of course she'll be pleased. She's sure already that the job will be good. Doris has been given the right words to say, and she's been shown how to say them. Another thing your salesman should know about customers is that clothes are personal items to them. They value the things they wear. And they don't like to see any garments manhandled. Good night. George may never get another order from this lady. It's important for salesmen to understand that every garment should be treated as if it were the most expensive suit or gown. A neat bag is as important to soiled garments as it is to cleaned garments. The customer will remember this, and the next time she wants her favorite dress cleaned, she'll know who to call.
Use a definite advertising campaign.
Now, with your business methods completely modernized and your employees on the way to being salespeople, the last step is to plan intelligent advertising helps for them. What are there besides local newspapers and occasional radio bulletins that you can use? There are many advertising helps and entire campaigns available to every dry cleaner. Tags and signs to call attention to seasonal specials. Stickers for inside and outside the package to keep customers reminded of your service. Attractive displays for your window, counter, and walls. Carefully designed packages for cleaned garments that carry a selling message into the home. Direct mail literature that keeps you in constant touch with both customers and prospects. There are plenty of places where you can get help for an advertising campaign. Distributors and distributor salesmen are eager to help you, to give advice or demand assistance from experienced advertising departments. These men represent the manufacturers and suppliers of your machines, equipment, and fluids. They are the distributors and field representatives who serve the dry cleaning industry and are at your service every day. Cooperating with all these organizations are your various associations and national trade magazines, providing facts to help you with your modernization plans. This group is typical of men who call on you and are prepared to assist you with practical advertising helps that have proved their value in the field. They're also equipped to give intelligent, constructive criticism on the cleaning operation itself. They are conversant with many new chemicals, new fabrics, new methods. These men, backed by the country's leading research laboratories, that are constantly at work on cleaning problems are in the field 12 months out of the year to help you improve your operations and service wherever possible. Take advantage of these helps. It is for every dry cleaner to remember that there are other things for him to do besides turning out a good cleaning job. The people who are the tremendous market out of which you draw your profits expect modern methods from you. And you'll get your share of that market by using modern advertising, modern salesmanship, and modern business methods.